Let's talk about private events and how on earth is this consistent with behaviorism? Here's what happened. Skinner had this radical idea that there are elements of mentalism that should be considered in the analysis of behavior. It's not that he wanted to do psychotherapy or talk about penis envy, but he did believe that there were environmental variables that are intrinsic to a person and not observable or measurable by someone else outside of that organism. This probably shook all those methodological behaviorists to the core, and probably how we got the name radical behaviorism, because that was some crazy stuff, right, Skinner? And basically, this new radical school of thought meant accepting that there are private variables that can control behavior, and there are behaviors that are private, like a private headache evokes the public behavior of taking an aspirin or going like this. When I see a picture of a bunny rabbit, a public stimulus, it makes me think of my dad, a private response. It could also make me smile, a public response, or feel happy, a private response. And what Skinner was getting at is that these private variables, these private events, matter also. We can't get a complete picture of a person's behavior without including these elements in our analysis of their behavior. Now, Skinner still believed that these things needed to be measurable and observable. And of course, private events can only be measured by self-reports. But for all of those healthy skeptics, yes, self-reports are measures. If it can be counted, it is measurement, even if you're the only one who observed it. Skinner, you're so radical.